Hello everyone, my name is EquilibriumEST and this is my Witcher 3 gameplay series, episode number 128. And I am playing Blood and Wine DLC. And currently I am trying to enhance my mutations. Damnations.
No point going in wearing full gear. Gotta drop my armor, leave my weapons.
What?
Professor's mutagens might work on me as they did on his son. Well, time to find out.
Yeah, this might be a really bad idea. So okay, so I can mutate now. Okay, that looks good. Whoa. I don't even know which one. Whoa. Okay, I think I need this one. Okay, that's a good one, I think. But it seems that I need ability points. Which is a bummer that I didn't know it and I spent mine. Oh well. Okie doke, we are out of here.
A power cell for portals. Feels dead. Maybe a sign will revive it.
Okay, it's the bear again. Well, I don't have anything against the bear, so let him be. Okay, so as there are no level requirement, I would think that perhaps it has something to do with some racing over there. So I don't touch those quests right now. So next in line would be, well, the main quest. Time to do the main quest. Whoa.
Positively whirling.
Yeah, it's difficult to navigate tight spaces with this horse. So the positive side about running around with your horse is that you will discover fast travel waypoints.
Sounds of a fight. Have to hurry.
Move it.
Damn it. Killer must still be here. Killed with a single blow. Cellar, gotta be. Claw wounds from 5 separate claws, spread of a small human hand. River Muck carried the body in his cart. trouble knocking over the cart. Woman from the inn was wearing this coat.
That's weird.
Busted ribs, blood from the ears. Took a solid hit. Massacred by a vampire. Not an Ekimura, though, or a Fletter. Bruxa, gotta be. Throat torn open by man-like jaws. Man-like, except for long fangs. Footprints. Small, bare feet. Lead deeper into the cellar. Fell down the stairs, broke his neck. Hurled against the wall with great force. Took a lot of strength to batter this down. Took a lot of strength to batter this down.
Okay.
And moon dust could be lifesavers.
Should I save, maybe? Probably.
You
Hello?
Saw you at the inn. I know what you are. Don't know why you killed these people, though. Clearly wasn't for their blood. We don't have to fight.
You are wrong.
Uh-oh.
I cannot let you leave.
Amputated. Body was quartered, just as I thought. Laid in water for some time. Head swollen, and something took a few bites out of it. Something in the throat. A pouch, bulging with coins. Guardian Florins from several different provinces. If the murderer did this, means we're dealing with a sentient thinking beast. Body was chopped up after death. Blows struck with great force, but bones sliced through, not crushed. Creature that killed him had long claws, sharp as a witcher's blade. First sank its claws into the victim's heart. No Bruxa did this. Third hand. A spare? Except it's clearly not the victim's. Guardsmen must have not noticed it as they picked everything up. How's this possible? Still warm, blood still flowing.
So that is a vampire hand. Regenerate.
Never heard of that happening to their severed limbs, though. Or of their limbs seeming completely alive after so much time. Examine the tissue more closely later. Might learn something.
Where did you put that moving hand?
So, murderer was clearly a monster, but not a Bruxa. But then why'd the Bruxa come here for the severed hand? And who does the hand belong to? Why the hell's it still warm?
Okay, vampire's not warm.
Out shoved down the victim's throat. What's the significance? And why was he chopped up into pieces? Lots of questions, no answers so far. Need to know about the other victims. I'll ask Palmerin to get me in to see the Duchess.
Just as if nothing bad has happened. What the hell?
Duchess, urgently.
All right, you scamps. Store is done. Go find your parents.
But Sir Palmerin, what about the story of Ritik and the dragon?
A tale's for another time. But take a good look at the man who stands before you now. This is Geralt of Rivia, the master witcher who lent his valiant hand to the defeat of the giant Goliath.
Master Witcher, is it true virtue always trumps villainy?
Yeah, virtue always wins.
But the Black Knight, he's a villain and he wins.
The cutter of Casteldaccia, too.
Moral victory, that's what counts.
Rubbish!
Now, that will do for questions. Go find your parents. Her Enlightened Highness has doubtless arrived at the tourney grounds to watch the battle in the arena. If we hurry, we'll be in time to speak with her before the spectacle begins.
Lead the way. Who's fighting? Nilfgaardian gladiators?
Close, but not quite. As you will soon see.
Someone's gonna fight a Shalemar? Leaving some bells on its tail to confuse it, slow it down?
Whatever is the problem? The beast is a gift, from the Emperor, no less.
Shouldn't torment the beast. How would you like to be dumped in an arena, blindfolded with a string of
pity a monster. You, a witcher.
I slay monsters who are a threat to humans. You're out to humiliate one to entertain a crowd. No knight will gain any glory from this. Who's going to fight the beast?
Guillaume, the young man you met.
Yeah. Mentioned he'd promised his heart's capture a monster trophy.
Great love demands great sacrifices.
I think he loses. Maybe.
I dedicate my imminent victory to fair Lady Vivian.
Whoops, wrong thing to say, maybe.
It's begun. The fight shall have to end first. We must wait.
It's not over yet.
Damn it.
Uh-oh.
We have to help him.
Oh, well. Uh-oh.
Witcher.
But lost your nerve.
To death.
God damn it.
The Shelmal is defeated by Geralt of Rivia, master of the witchering trade. Behold, as the last gasps of life seep from the beast.
Master Geralt, do what you must. Finish the deed!
It suffered enough.
The monster lies slain! The fight is done! Praised be the victors!
Forgive me. I am not as nimble as in my younger years.
You fought bravely. Thanks for your help. Guillaume?
The lad came damned close to dying.
I'm fine. Not hurt at all. Vivian?
Smile as befits a hero and keep silent. Speech clearly paints you. She approaches.
Geralt, we must talk.
Vivian, you shall talk later in the medic's tent.
Geralt, magnificent, breathtaking.
Your grace.
We knew that to summon you was a brilliant idea. We are delighted, ravished to have struck upon it.
And I'm truly honored.
See to our young hero. Hop, hop, for we must make off with Geralt. We should talk. We had been long awaiting your arrival, had nearly lost hope. Then suddenly, that entrance, so spectacular.
Your grace, Shelmars are dangerous creatures, even to knights in full plate armor.
Nonsense. In Toussaint, knights have battled beasts for mere glory since time immemorial. True. Guillaume suffered a few bumps, scars, and bruises, but in return gained eternal glory as he who slew the monster.
Mm-hmm. What about the crowd? Say the Shelmar had vaulted into the stands. Would have been a massacre.
Geralt, though we value your fortuitous intervention in the arena, we would remind you your services have been retained, and as shall soon become clear, you will be generously compensated. For completing another task altogether.
Your Grace, my contract. I'd like to discuss it.
Naturally, but not here. We shall need Damien. He led the investigation pending your arrival. But wherever could he be? Come, we must find him.
Okay. That was one harsh beast, I have to say.
Tell us, have you come alone? Or did Viscount Julian accompany you?
Wish to see Dandelion, Your Grace?
Yes. I mean, no. Yes. But solely to tell him we regret. Yes, deeply regret rescinding the death sentence we so justly handed down upon him. If we could turn back time, we would make certain he sat in a tower till he rotted. No, we would ensure he was broken on the wheel, then drawn, hanged, and quartered. Ah, the very man we would entrust with these tasks. Damien de la Tour, captain of my personal guard.
Your Grace. Witcher.
Greetings. Sorry to have to tell you, but but the guardsman handling the last victim's body.
I know already. The creature in the cellar of Corvo Bianco. Was it the beast?
No. A Bruxa, a kind of vampire. Not the beast, but tied to it in some way.
You know this how?
Through careful analysis of the evidence, both on the riverbank and at Corvo Bianco.
Do you mean to insinuate the investigation thus far has been sloppy?
Geralt insinuates nothing of the sort. We must listen to him attentively.
I examined the body of the beast's last victim. Might have found something. Need to analyze it. A quiet place, that's what I could use most right now. And maybe the help of an alchemist or a mage. Also like to hear all you know about the previous victims. Take it Sir Delatour is my man for that.
Firstly, call me Damien, please. Secondly, you should know I spoke against summoning you here. I've heard much about you. You bring trouble, or thus far have, always. And we've enough trouble as it is. Yet we are capable of defeating the beast on our own, without an outsider's help. I've no doubt about it.
Damien, we settled the matter of the Witcher's employ some time past. Definitively. Since you have broached it nonetheless, let us discuss Geralt's pay. Are the legends true? Do Witchers usually demand that which you find at home, yet did not expect?
Not quite, Your Grace. Law of surprise? It's something we invoke at times, but rarely. Usually we just take gold.
Disappointing. This law sounds rather romantic. On the other hand, on returning to the palace, we would likely find impatient petitioners or a set of sample fabrics for a new dress. Poor rewards, both. I fear you'd not have much use for any of the surprises we are likely to come upon. Thus, we've decided you shall receive the deed to a vineyard, Corvo Bianco, and a sum of coin. You will doubtless consider this adequate. Title to the vineyard shall be given to you at once. Surely you'll need lodgings while you hunt. The coin, however, will be yours only once you have slain the beast.
Lovely, generous gesture, Your Grace. But Corvo Bianco, isn't it the Duchy's temporary morgue?
Is it now? The Chancellery's bungled things again, we fear. Not to be left unsupervised for one instant. Yet, in its mood, a morgue should present minimal problems to a witcher. What's more, nothing enhances a wine's reputation better than a grim legend.
Thank you, Your Grace. I accept the contract, of course. But as I said before, I'll need some information. How did it start? Who was the first victim?
Crespi was the first to die. He was famed once for his many glorious tournament victories. Then he grew old, hung up his sword, and took to winemaking.
Crespi was not loved by the wine merchants. He was ruthless in business and thought to cheat many a time. He asked us for a dispensation from all court ceremonies. We did not grant it. We could not. Once you've taken the oath of a knight, you remain a knight till death.
How'd he die? Where'd they find the body?
Quite unusual, the circumstance. He was at a feast when suddenly one of his fellow feastgoers noticed he was missing. The town watch found him an hour later. On his hands and knees, propped against the town pillory, his sword hanging from his neck. He had died of wounds inflicted with claws, not a weapon. Blows of great force.
So he died suddenly, but the body was on its knees, meaning someone posed it.
So it seems.
Second murder. Tell me what you know.
In the city, there are certain nooks. No one reasonable ventures there after dark. Ramon Dulac's corpse was found in one such place. With the first murder, terror gripped the city. Its inhabitants grew wary, kept to safe areas. Consequently, news of the second victim came to us from a group of concerned cut purses.
Criminals fear the beast? Telling in a way. Take it you've excluded the possibility that Ramon died at the hands of these bandits.
Do you believe me an amateur? Not hands, but claws killed Ramon Dulac. The wound was deep, clean.
His body was found in the gutter, dressed in nightshirt and cap, a pillow placed under his head, and his sword replaced by a bed warmer. Ramon de Lac, a knight who but a dozen years past was an advisor to our father, the Duke.
Someone went to a lot of trouble to make him look ridiculous. Maybe revenge was the motive.
It's not out of the question. Dulac had shady dealings with the criminal underworld, but no one ever came forth with concrete proof of any misdoings.
So, first two victims were knights, best years behind them.
The same could be said of the third. Sir Delacroix was wont to claim that in modern times, knights face new challenges, enterprise being the latest addition to the chivalric virtues.
He made a veritable fortune in the grain trade. Palmerin even nicknamed him Sir della Stinchi.
Found a coin pouch on his body. Contained florins dating from various times, hailing from different provinces of the Empire.
Delacroix loved coin, true, but had no patience for numismatics.
Lots of similarities between the victims. All the bodies were found in strange places under extraordinary circumstances. Seems the murderer, whoever or whatever it is, has some meaning to convey.
These were honorable men. We are horrified by the disdain, the disrespect with which they were treated. These were knights of Toussaint. Blast it.
Might be the point. From what you say, none was a model of virtue. Ever considered that's what the beast's trying to draw attention to?
All the murdered men were knights who swore fealty to the five chivalric virtues. And even if the
Knights of Toussaint swear fealty to what virtues, exactly?
Honor, wisdom, generosity, valor and compassion.
Five virtues. Why are they so important to your knights?
Strange question.
Your Grace, forgive me. I'm a foreigner trying to understand another land's customs.
You are forgiven. According to legend, the virtues we cultivate were bestowed upon us by the Lady of the Lake. How we truly came to espouse them, none remember. In Toussaint, we believe men of low birth should be simple-hearted and obedient. We expect much more, however, of our knights. They are to be soldiers and courtiers, lords and servants. Thus, the need for clear moral guidelines. At the time of his dubbing, a knight vows to demonstrate, throughout his life, honor, wisdom, generosity, valor, and compassion.
Beast seems to be pointing up moral decay, denouncing it. Victims were all humiliated. Might have been murdered to emphasize their lack of specific chivalric virtues.
Honor, compromised by the pillory. Wisdom, by ridicule. Generosity by a coin pouch shoved down a throat. It seems to fit, true, though not perfectly.
Can't discount the theory if it's on the lips of everyone in town. Say our reasoning's right. Next murder will be just as showy and denounce the victim's lack of the fourth virtue, valor. We can also assume that victim will be an elder knight.
Let's think. At the moment, all the knights are either at the tourney grounds or in the palace gardens. Our annual hare hunt shall begin there shortly. Have you heard of the custom?
Milton mentioned something. Seemed excited to prance around in a bunny costume. Not sure why. Hang on. Strange circumstances. A knight advanced in years. The famed cowardice of rabbits.
Could it be that simple? Is Milton de Peyrac Peyren the next victim?
Milton also knew Delacroix. Told me so down by the river.
Damien! To miss something so obvious. De Peyrac Peyren, Crespi, Delacroix, and de Lac formed a knightly team. It was years ago, but
they were a team?
They were close friends, tightly knit, and as such earned the trust of our father, the Duke. We often witnessed him turn to them with delicate matters. Later, their paths diverged.
Unlikely to be a coincidence. Beast must know it too. It's a lead, I'm sure. Your Grace, we need to find Milton. Immediately.
Rather problematic. You see, the garden entertainments are due to start, and he's disguised as the hare, hiding somewhere, waiting for some tipsy courtiers to find him. The hare's hiding place is a carefully guarded secret.
We must call off the game, at once.
First and foremost, we must remain calm. Damien. Order the garden searched immediately, but discreetly. By no means can we disrupt the festivities. Panic will only incite the beast to strike sooner. And you, Witcher, follow me. My gardens, my night, I shall take the fore. A murder is out of the question. I will not allow it, not near my palace. Horses! Ready our horses! Your Grace!
Uh-oh.
What the hell? Why, I should...
Your Highness, I...
Mind it doesn't get wrinkled. All right!
Hey! That is silk! Be careful! Give it to me!
Oh. Oh. Damn, that's going to be one long episode.
Seems right at home in a saddle.
Never thought I'd live.
Watch it.
It's her. It's her. Clear of her. Clear the way, I said.
Smearing his
head. Ow!
Some rope.
Is this part of the kill?
Just round the corner.
Hurry.
We must go to where the game is being held. The participants must find a unicorn's horn, a golden fish, and a phoenix egg. With these in hand, they can deduce where the hare, Milton, hides.
Mean we need to find those things too?
We've no other option, but time is of the essence, so we shall have to break the rules.
Okay, so right here, right now, it's time to end episode one, number 128. So this interesting chase will continue in the next episode. So thank you for watching me, subscribe to my YouTube channel, follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next game episode. Bye bye.